Yeah, I do wonder what they're gonna show off though, because they've announced so many titles and have then shown nothing for them, you know?
Yeah, like what games? Like Starfield, of course.
Yeah, Starfield, stuff. Elder Scrolls 6, Redfall, Avowed, that, you know, Western RPG from what's their face studios. You know, the not Bethesda. They did the Outer Worlds. I just can't remember their name.
Oh, Obsidian.
Yeah, Obsidian. Yeah. A couple of other titles too. And so far, the only thing they've actually released for the new Xbox is like Halo, and that was delayed by a year from when it was supposed to come out. So. And of course, you know, Halo's released already, so we're not going to see any of that.
Yeah.
Unless it's like, you know, the update for the multiplayer.
Who knows? Hey, at least they have games.
maybe. They might have games. I haven't seen them yet.
I'm just waiting for the inevitable Nintendo show at this point, you know?
Yeah, I'm hoping it's on Wednesday.
That'd be nice.
Yeah. It's either going to be Wednesday or Thursday, right?
Yeah.
And I'm hoping it's Wednesday, because I have off Wednesday.
Oh, man, one more minute.
I hope this doesn't run for 2 hours.
Oh god, that'd suck.
Yeah. Because the Summer Games Fest ran for 2 hours and it was very boring.
Yeah. Phil, oh, it says 95 minutes.
Okay, so it's like an hour and a half.
Yeah. Ugh.
It could be worse.
I'd like shorter, you know.
Me too.
Just, you know, have it short and packed.
Yeah. Especially since they never actually show anything. There was one trailer for a game in the Summer Games Fest. It was for an RTS. But I didn't know that until the trailer was over and they told me it was an RTS.
Oh, it's starting. Oh man, look at all these mature ratings.
Yeah. Console exclusive.
Oh, that means it's also on PC.
This is a Bethesda game. Oh, this must be Redfall.
Rumor has it safe at the church. There's blood in the baptismal font, and pastor's gone missing. And my genius plan was to investigate it alone.
Right.
Of course. Don't trust.
Okay, that's a nice atmosphere in this.
Oh shit.
Oh. Is this supposed to just be Left 4 Dead, but with vampires?
Yeah, is this Redfall? I think so.
I'm almost positive it's Redfall.
Yeah.
What was that?
Because I wasn't expecting Redfall to have this much, like, more atmospheric stuff like this.
I've seen the movement in the dark. I've seen the shadow. I see you.
Oh, Lord!
I'll bite out your heart.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I like panicky, close-range gunfights, so yeah, this is looking good.
Kiss your ass goodbye.
Jacob! Oh, thank God!
Come on, find the others and beat feet.
You know,
Redfall used to look like it was straight out of a postcard. A picturesque island off the coast of Massachusetts. The bustling.
I do wonder how the actual structure is going to be. Is it supposed to be co-op?
Yeah.
But is it going to be like mission structured like Left 4 Dead or?
Yeah, more.
People started vanishing, and those who didn't sold out. Big time. Fast forward, basically everyone's either a vampire, a cultist trying to be
maybe more like Dead Island style, where it's kind of like an open world RPG that just happens to have 4-player multiplayer.
Yeah.
Blocked out the sun and pushed back all the water, totally cut us off from the outside world. Gotta admit though, if I have to be stuck on an island full of vampires, I'm glad it's with y'all.
Feelings mutual, I guess.
Aw, thanks, Jacob. We've also got Remy, our engineer genius, and her little robot buddy.
She means you, Bribon. Who's a good robot? Who's the best robot?
And our resident expert.
Oh my god, you got engineer.
Last but not least, yours truly. I have these weird powers.
I'm guessing it's supposed to kind of be like Borderlands 2. Where it's just co-op and every character is different, you know?
Yeah.
I bet the answers we need are inside those tourist traps turned fortresses.
Spotted some bloodsuckers in their fan club near the festival grounds. Let's start there. Ghosting out.
Straight at him, or just slip past.
Let's just get this done. On my mark. Oh shit, blood bag! They know we're here. Look alive!
This one is mine.
Going up!
Cryptid hunter's intuition tells me there's a nest nearby.
Your what?
Duff, that's not a thing.
Found something.
Oh, now I simply must go in there.
What is that? Where does it go?
Ooh. Some kind of collective consciousness.
That's they impossible. Went to fucking Psychonauts world.
There's the movie theater. I used to come here all the time.
Sorry, my computer just crashed. I'm back.
Okay. It's okay, they went to Psychonauts. They fought some vampires and then they went through a door that led them into a Psychonauts level.
Okay, good. Okay, well, we're in a church now. Take back Redfall. Okay, I'm caught up, right? Yeah. Okay.
Close enough.
Good.
Yeah.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Oh, yeah, this looks cool.
Yeah, it looks fine.
Wait, day one of Game Pass.
Oh my god, Silksong. I was not expecting you to show up in fucking the Xbox show.
What?
Yeah, look, Silksong.
What the fuck? You're 2 seconds ahead of me, so.
Yeah.
Hey, cool.
Oh my god. I'm so caught off guard because I was expecting this in the Nintendo showcase, at the Xbox one. I didn't even know this was gonna come to the Xbox. They said it was like only gonna come to like PC and Switch.
Yeah, that'd be odd, wouldn't I feel like?
Yeah. Well, they did say that Hollow Knight sold the best on Switch and PC.
Yeah, that makes sense. I bought it on both. I bought it on PC when like Hollow Knight first came out, then I heard there was gonna be a Switch port, and I'll be like, oh, I gotta play this on Switch. So I waited like 3 years.
Yeah, this looks so fucking good.
Wow. Hollow Knight with more polish? Is that physically possible?
You know, like, they're gonna drop a release date now.
Wild.
Okay, but when is it? Or is that just supposed to announce that it's actually coming to Xbox?
Or that it still exists.
Yeah.
Oh, well, more world premieres. Console launch exclusive. The console's already launched. Splatoon?
No. Nickelodeon slime.
Okay. Hell.
Oh, that's. I was Morty? Like, I know that voice actor. It's. It's the Morty.
Morty. Including you. All right, you're about to. I don't want a Morty gun. Okay, alien guns is a fun idea.
You squeeze them and then they shit.
Oh yeah, that's one of my die fast. Don't worry, it's easy to make more. Hey there, I'm Knifey.
Weird.
Well, it's, you know, it's like a Rick and Morty game, you know, but, you know, not Rick and Morty, but, you know, basically Rick and Morty.
It looks like a pretty unique FPS, though, in terms of gameplay, at least.
Yeah.
Ew. Gross.
Eye on life.
Strange. What?
We haven't seen any, like, there they are.
Welcome.
I was wondering
the Xbox
where they were.
And Bethesda Game Showcase. Today, we're doing something we've never done before.
Get out of here. We don't need to see people. Just show us games.
Focused on games you can play over the next 12 months.
Like the millisecond I say we haven't seen anyone yet, and then somebody shows up.
Racing experiences, gripping narratives, compelling strategy titles, and my favorite, the most anticipated open world RPG of the last 20 years.
But Elden Ring already came out.
In the year ahead. And the best part is, with Xbox, you'll be able to play those games in more ways than ever before. You can play on your console, PC, or on the go with Xbox Cloud Gaming. You can play with who you want, where you want, and when you want. Today, we're going to show you more than 30 titles that are coming to Game Pass. And that is on top of the hundreds of titles coming to members over the next year. Our next announcement shows that the benefits of Game Pass go well beyond the console. We are thrilled to be working with an iconic team that has built some of the most played, most watched franchises in the entire world. And now, all Game Pass members will be able to unlock the benefits for these incredible games on PC and mobile.
For over a decade, players have created a thriving culture of competition and creativity.
It's Riot Games.
From clutch plays with friends to unforgettable moments in esports. Amazing creations that are blown our mind. Our community has continued.
That's okay. They're not going to talk about League of Legends. They're probably going to talk about one of their other lame ass games.
Proud to invite the Xbox.
I only care if they bring up Project L and officially announce Teemo.
Yeah. Subscribers, why don't you just play the card game and use a Teemo deck?
I've heard that card game's really good, actually.
Yeah,
it's actually
it
like really easy to get into compared to other card games.
It is. It's actually really fun.
Thank you. For coming on this journey.
Teemo decks are really cool too. The gimmick is that they plant traps in the enemy's deck so that when they draw cards, they take damage.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
Oh my god, they're adding. Imagine playing League on a controller though.
Yeah.
Who is this?
Oh, that's from Valorant. It's from their not. CSGO.
Does anyone play Valorant aside from, like, League of Legends players?
People who like CSGO but are sick of CSGO.
Okay, I guess they exist.
That's about it. Yeah.
Are you just gonna advertise games that everyone's already played right now?
Yeah.
Like, League
I'm
of
not
Legends
100%
is like,
sure what they're advertising.
I feel it's just that it's on Game Pass.
Yeah.
Their stuff.
Oh, I get it.
But it's like, I know that League of Legends exists. You don't gotta advertise it.
Oh, I get it, I get it. If you get Game Pass, you get to unlock all the champions automatically in League.
Oh! Oh, that's kind of neat, actually.
Yeah. This is a very long League of Legends advertisement.
It's like, yeah.
But they're not even showing off any of the new games. The ones I actually might care about.
It's games that have been out for like 90 years.
Well, some of these have only been out for like 2 years.
I know. But where's the Ziggs game? That's just Bitrip Runner. Is that on Game Pass?
Maybe.
What is a little legend anyway in a Teamfight Tactics? I mean, just
it's
guys
your little
you have
mascot
on...
that dances sometimes. Sorry, that's about it.
But very exciting. He's not dead yet. But now what's this? Dead crows?
It's that rat game, isn't it?
How?
Right? It's the game with the sea of rats.
Isn't that a sequel to something? It
concerns everybody. Yes. It's the sequel to the Sea of Rat game. I don't remember the title. I think it's a Plague Tale.
That sounds right.
Sea of rats.
Remember, yeah. No more. That's a lot of rats. No more
yeah.
Hey, they are showing gameplay this presentation, though. I guess I can't fault them for that.
Yeah. Even the League of Legends thing had some gameplay in it.
I know.
I mean, everybody knows what League of Legends plays like.
Yeah. So. They just hit each other.
Yeah.
Awkwardly hit under tables.
Dude, this is just like Sly Cooper. And I hit under a table in Sly Cooper.
Oh my god. You're only making it worse. Oh my gosh, you can go through foliage like Horizon Zero Dawn, I don't know. I'm tired of being afraid. I'll show them that it's over. Oh, and you can violently murder people. Nothing like every game.
Yes.
Yeah. You are not them. Oh my god, you did not get to feed that guy to the rats.
It is funny because you're like a few seconds behind, but it's okay.
I know. Nothing I could do. I tried refreshing and it just kept the same 2 seconds behind.
Yeah.
So, oh well. YouTube streaming, what are you gonna do?
Yeah.
But it's A1 of Game Pass.
Xbox has a game studio. Oh, it's Forza. Wow, that sure is an engine.
Yeah.
And a car.
Well, they're driving.
Wow. Graphics. That I can't really appreciate because I don't have this turned up all the way to highest quality.
It does look fairly good.
Oh, yeah. But where is Ridge Racer?
That's in the Sony conference, but they didn't show
it. Oh, okay. You should have some goofier cars. I want to ride like a clown car in that game.
I think in order to get the sillier cars, you have to play like the other Forza game.
Okay.
The Lego one.
And state-of-the-art immersion. Oh, that looks really cool, actually, the Lego one. Showcase the Xbox Series X and S consoles,
including techniques like real-time ray tracing on track. They should just bring back Twisted Metal. The most technically
advanced racing game I'm shocked ever made. They haven't!
I mean, I heard Sony was, like, doing a Twisted Metal TV show or something. Forza Motorsport.
That's bizarre, and even though it hasn't had a game in, like, 10 years.
Yeah. This track has been a fan favorite
since the original Motorsport launch. At least Carmageddon is back. That got an entry like a year ago. For the
first time, Forza Motorsport, fully dynamic time of day, brings Maple Valley to life in stunning detail.
What you are seeing is an in-engine gameplay demo presented using a single camera with no cuts. Let's jump in with the M8.
But are they gonna pull up a car on stage? That's a real question.
Do it!
Yeah.
This looks really nice, I'll bet. Like,
it does.
Oh man, I'd like to drive around this pretty place in the fall. It's nice and fall. Improvement in the fidelity of our physics simulation.
Definitely looks better than the new Pokemon game.
Everything you see is new and has been captured with photogrammetry. Oh man, look at like the, you can see specs and like the tar.
Yeah. See the cracks?
That's wild.
It's honestly a little too much. Like, it feels excessive.
I don't know, if you want to flex that 4K TV, this is the game to do it, I guess.
Yeah. 3D vegetation, skies and clouds,
they all demonstrate a generational leap. Oh man, they're gonna get me interested just by having a pretty autumn setting.
Yeah. Let's advance time again. Although it does kind of feel like a bit of a case of like, you know, don't try to chase realism in art. That's what cameras are for, you know? Is a fundamental
system to the new Forza. I mean, yeah. But, you know, sometimes I want really realism games, and the only way to get more real than this is FMV games.
Yeah, which reminds me.
They're too scared to do FMV.
I was thinking about it because, you know, Sony announced The Last of Us remake, you know.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, it's just like, they're going to do another remake for The Last of Us in like 5 to 10 years, and it's going to be an FMV game.
That'd be sick. I'd play that.
Yeah. It's like, we can't make it any more movie-like than this, so we decided to just make it a actual movie that you occasionally press buttons in. Because, like, they're doing a Last of Us remake, and they're also making, like, a Last of Us TV show.
The Last of Us TV show is actually happening, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. They just finished shooting the first season.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Bring out incredible detail in the gold
heat wrap, anodized aluminum, and carbon fiber. This is like the most like masturbatory graphics trailer I've ever seen.
It really is.
It's like, oh, the ray tracing.
I mean, it's the only way they can really evolve the genre, you know, where it's just like, it's like the cars already drive realistically. We've already gotten that down, so it's like, yeah. I guess we can just make them look more realistic, you know?
They have a really good damage model, but I guess Burnout's already perfected that.
Yeah. Because it's like, if realism is your end goal in both gameplay and, you know, graphics.
Yeah.
And if you've already perfected the gameplay to a point, you know, it's like you can only make it look better at that point. Makes everything feel more connected. Cars reflecting onto other cars. Cars reflect in their own mirrors, bodywork, brake rotors, and wings.
Things just feel more natural, more real. These reflections, though. We believe that the accuracy of our overhauled physics, the beauty of our cars and tracks, our new dynamic time of day, advanced car damage,
and real-time ray tracing on track lead to a generational leap in immersion. This is the all-new Forza Motorsport.
Neato.
That sunset very quickly.
I know. I wouldn't call that real-time Xbox.
Yeah.
Who do I call Xbox now? Is Phil Spencer still around?
I think so.
Okay. I'm just going to pretend Phil Spencer made all of these trailers then.
Yeah.
Microsoft's longest-running franchise.
Helicopters, gliders, and new aircraft. Oh, so, you know, that plane sim. Flight simulator.
That's my favorite. That is Microsoft's best franchise. I'll give them that.
It really is. Look, now you can fly the Wright Brothers plane.
Oh my god, and survive for like 2 minutes.
This must be an update for the most recent one.
Yeah. Was that the 2021? I can't remember its name. Don't worry, they just, you know what? Screw it. Let's do the whole planet in excruciating detail.
Yeah.
I mean, to be fair, the original flight sim did have the whole planet, but, you know, it wasn't that accurate. Yeah. Okay, as much as I, like, appreciate, like, the tech behind flight sim, you can't get me excited for this trailer. Like,
I mean, they added helicopters. Around. That's literally flying cars.
Like, no, actually just add flying cars. That I'm excited.
That's what helicopters are. They just don't call them flying cars because that would be silly. Okay, put wheels on a helicopter, it's a flying car now.
Okay. Then also make it like one of those, like a boat, and we're set.
Yeah.
Oh, it's on Steam as well. Nice.
Whoa. Is that a Metal Gear?
What?
No, it's the Halo thingy.
See, this is what they need.
Yeah.
I want to drive around stupid Halo cars.
Yeah, now you can go in space.
We found a world was too small for the newest Microsoft Flight Simulator, so we added all of space.
Yeah, we've added the entire universe, painstakingly created in exclusive 4K detail.
Next summer, we will be adding the multiverse.
Yeah. Oh, right.
Oh, no, Blizzard.
All right. Fucking Microsoft owns this now. I forgot.
Overwatch.
Yeah, Microsoft owns this now, remember?
You know there's more out there, don't you?
Even the best journeys end.
I thought Overwatch 2 was just but like, I thought they were just realized no one cared.
Right around the corner. I mean, they do, but they're still gonna release it.
Are they gonna have a plot this time?
No. But you know, everybody will buy it. And then be like, well, that's just Overwatch 1 again, and it's kind of lame. And then they'll stop playing.
Yeah. Okay.
Nice work, team.
Man, I haven't played Overwatch in years. I don't hate Overwatch, it's just I haven't played it in years.
Yeah. You know what's funny? I, like, refused to play it for years. I eventually finally gave it a try. Just because my sister really wanted to play with me. I think I played, like, 3 matches with my sister. And then I played a little bit on my own time, but within like a month, I was like, this is boring, and just stopped playing and went back to TF2.
Yeah.
Because the game is just like not mechanically deep enough to like actually warrant how hard they try to be, like, you know.
Yeah, there's like a lot of champions, but you can't push any of the individual champions to any like ridiculous degrees.
Yeah. Where it's just like
there's no crazy skill ceiling the way there is for something, I don't know, like rocket jumping, for example.
Yeah. I mean, you already showed this character in the trailer, so why are you revealing her now? She was just in the earlier trailer. Why'd you put her in the first trailer if she's supposed to be new here?
This is like when Smash Bros. Had the Bowser Jr. trailer like 2 weeks after the game came out.
Yeah, it's like we already know.
A free-for-all with zero rules.
What is she, Mad Max lady?
Yes.
Gets the throne. I thought Overwatch was like a utopia. Where is she? This is like a shithole.
We're the same place where, like, Junkrat lives, I assume.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Garbage land.
Garbage land.
So, you know, Australia.
Oof. Oof.
You know, Australia in the Overwatch universe. Which is the exact opposite of Australia in the TF2 universe. Because they want to try to be original.
Australia, the TF2 universe is the opposite.
Exactly, that's what I just said. Overwatch's Australia is the opposite of TF2's Australia.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm not going to see you on October 4th. I'll go play Overwatch 1 instead. Man, it's so nice for Xbox to have a game studio, unlike Sony anymore.
Oh yeah, that is nice.
I'm still so sad about Japan Studios.
What about the history that could have been if you were its architect? I mean, honestly, this generation so far has really felt like a repeat of like the PS3 and Xbox 360 gen. You know,
yeah, Sony's way too overconfident.
Yeah, Microsoft pulls out all the stops to go hard as fuck, you know?
Yeah, yeah. How would you lead them in this? And Nintendo's selling really well while just existing in their own bubble.
Yeah.
Yeah, we really are that same generation again. History repeated.
Yeah, and you know, next gen is gonna repeat again. Xbox is gonna get overconfident. They're gonna do a bunch of dumb shit. Game Pass is gonna turn to garbage, you know, because they can't sustain that forever. Sony's gonna get off of their high horse and then take their head out of their ass and start doing shit not stupid. Or at the very least, that Xbox is gonna fuck up so much that it will give Sony the opportunity to step in and just not fuck up, you know?
Yeah. It's good to be here. Celebrating what's it's a history game. There was no gameplay in that trailer. A few of the projects. Liars.
It was a strategy RPG. You know, it's like Civilization. Redfall. And the world's first. Actually, I don't even know what the game they showed off. I wasn't paying attention. Redfall is
from the studio. It was some history.
It was a turn-based strategy game. So it was a grand strategy game, like, you know, Civilization.
Okay. Right,
I wasn't sure what
Civ
it was.
Instead.
I think it was from the Civ devs. If you're looking for
something to sink your teeth into,
I don't remember what studio they showed, but they were like from the people who revolutionized the genre. So I'm assuming it's the Sid devs, because who else would it be?
Kidnapped Sid Meier.
That has never been explored in any Elder Scrolls game. The Elder Scrolls Online High Isle comes to Xbox next week. Does anybody play the Elder Scrolls Online? For generations. I don't think I've ever seen anyone actually talk about it.
Hey, that's not true. The Hyrox and Daggerfall. Liars. Daggerfall is the entire planet.
Yeah. And whispers of a sinister plot stoke the
flames of war. Then I got Hyrox cool. I have no clue where they're gonna set six, though. At the heart of the
conflagration. Like, in space.
For six. Yeah. Like, do you think they're gonna do the cat people desert or like the lizard people swamp?
I don't know. I think what they're gonna is that it's just Elder Scrolls 6 is just gonna be Starfield again, but in fantasy instead of sci-fi, where it's still in space, but you're playing as a knight. 25
this year. Oh, I've heard there apparently is in Elder Scrolls lore, like, the elves have a space program or something. I don't know anything about the details, but Elder Scrolls lore is wild. Expeditions the Pit is coming this September.
they're still updating Fallout 76.
Yeah, I thought they would have just ignored it. I mean, this game's only like $15.
Yeah. I guess they must have enough people still playing it. You know?
I mean, after like all the glitches were like fixed up, it's probably like fine. It's probably, and like they added NPCs, it's probably like just like a good enough Fallout game. I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, I know a handful of diehard Fallout fans that, you know, still play it.
Play Country Roads. Show Todd Howard. Pit.
Yeah.
Wow. You go fight ghouls in a pit.
Bethesda Game Studios has been busy, and not just with Fallout 76. After defining the role-playing genre with hits like Morrowind, Oblivion, Skyrim, Fallout 3, and Fallout 4, they're going even bigger with Starfield.
Okay, now later I get to see Starfield.
My good friend Todd Howard will be here to reveal more of their next epic RPG.
Oh, okay. They'll do it later. They're just reminding us to continue watching.
Todd's gonna be here.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Oh, I'm excited now.
I'm gonna try and like see if I can't, you know, reset this. That way we're not you know, desynced as much. Well, Hot Wheels in Forza. See, this is, I told you, you had to get the other Forza game in order to get the silly stuff. Is this the other Forza game?
Oh, it's... Yeah, this looks sick.
Yeah.
Although, I could just play Trackmania, which I already own. That's pretty much this.
Yeah.
But they don't have Hot Wheels in that, so...
Yeah. Alright, because this is the Forza Horizons, or whatever it's called.
Yeah. Honestly, I think every racing game should have tracks this hilarious.
That's true, they should.
Like, why not at this point? Especially if, like, hyper-realistic graphics, they're, like, even cooler.
Yeah. Add Sonic as a car in Forza.
Yes! Oh, that'd be sick. Just have a Sonic R DLC.
Yeah.
My dad tells stories of a terrible war that happened. Why did you say console launch exclusive? I thought the console's been out. And died
to give us a chance. No, they mean the game launches on the console exclusively. You have to wait a year before it comes to PC or whatever.
Okay. A dodo bird.
And here on Arrakis, and feathered dinosaurs.
Is this Ark?
Probably is.
Wasn't Ark supposed to have like Vin Diesel or something?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we had like Caveman in Fast and the Furious. It was like the best thing ever.
See, there he is, Vin Diesel.
Wow. Oh my God. He's really here.
It's Ark 2. Electric Boogaloo.
Fucking Vin Diesel on a T-Rex, the video game. That's launch exclusive.
They don't have the voice. What's this? It's Unreal Engine. Oh, this must be that game. What is this, Scorn?
Is this Dark Souls 3?
No.
Why did we get an H.R. Geiger tunnel?
Oh, yeah. Have you not seen this game before? They've shown it off like a dozen times over the past, like, 12 years.
I don't remember. What is this again?
It's called Scorn, I think. It's like an FPS where you're in H.R. Geiger land.
Okay. I like Geiger. Give me more Geiger in games. That's fair.
Yeah. It's been like, they've shown trailers off for it for like literally like 7 years at this point.
Wow. Oh, this looks gorgeous, so.
Yeah.
You know, gorgeous in a way that makes me want to throw up. That kind of gorgeous.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, the only good Geiger game is like Darkseid, and that's like a terrible adventure game from the 90s. So this is exciting.
It's finally coming out this year.
Wow.
When the gods first emerged from the great below, we saw them as saviors. Instead, they unleashed a pestilence on our world. No one yet knows if you can kill a god. I, for one, intend to find out.
Oh my god, you're fighting skeletons!
This looks so weird.
They looked like they were just like in a civil war camp, and now they're fighting skeletons of axes? What's going on?
Yeah, what the hell is this?
Is this a Souls-like?
No, it looks more like Ass Creed. Clone. But, you know, with magic.
I don't know, this looks weird.
I mean, gameplay-wise, it looks like Ass Creed.
Ass Creed.
You know. I mean, it looks better than Ass Creed, to be fair.
Oh no, big spiders. Okay, flintlock.
That actually looks neat.
Yeah, that kind of looks neat. You got like a weird raccoon thing.
Yeah.
If I see this play at day one of Game Pass one more time, I'm gonna freak.
Minecraft. They're releasing Minecraft 2!
Oh, it's finally here!
Well, they got Hatsune Miku to make this?
Legends hold great power.
What? It's from the creator of Minecraft.
Oh.
They are the dreams we weave.
Oh my god, is this gonna be a villager RPG?
Some legends tell of peace. You get to replay the events of Fallen Kingdom.
Is this gonna be a Minecraft RTS?
You know, that'll actually be kind of funny.
Yeah, you can build stuff on like Minecraft dungeons. This is Fallen Kingdom.
Yeah.
They keep trying to make the pigmen villains. Nah, the pigmen are chill. They're not invaders. They just chill in their house.
But the legends we hold dearest are legends of hope, of creativity, and of bravery.
See, I told you. It's just Fallen Kingdoms.
It totally is.
It's just the entire music video series.
Just did an epic RPG.
This is the legend of a united overworld.
This is so lame.
This has to be like an RTS, right?
Yeah, I think it's an RTS. Oh, I see a gameplay now. Oh, no, it might be like a RPG.
It's literally just...
Oh my gosh, it's like an action RPG like... about leading armies. That's actually really cool.
It's like, it is like an RTS, but you know, it's like a... It's one of those where you're... Yeah, it's like an action RTS.
Okay.
Where you're like, you're in the thing on the field, you know, kind of like Brutal Legends.
Okay.
Remember that Jack Black game? Where it was an action game that then turned into an RTS?
I never played that game. I know about it, but I never played it.
Yeah. I'm guessing it's like that.
What is this? We're seeing planets?
I think this might be Outer Worlds too. Or maybe it's something else.
Entirely. I'm not sure.
I don't know, there's been so many space games this not E3. New life for yourself.
Ready.
Okay, but when do I turn into the Lorax? Be like the Onceler from the Lorax. When the Lorax shows up.
Oh, that'd be sick. He's like a secret villain.
Yeah.
Like in this game, gotta fight him.
Well, it's more like a villain protagonist situation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And while you explored, you uncovered a mystery. This is like Slime Rancher with a mech. Oh, as multiplayer, okay. So you go farming with your mech friends. Lightyear Frontier. I didn't see Buzz Lightyear anywhere in that trailer. What are you talking about?
Yeah, I'm surprised Disney's not suing their asses real quick right now.
Yeah.
I'd think they'd have copyright to the word Lightyear at this point, considering how fucked up the copyright laws are.
Oh my god, it's a bunny! Oh my god, it's a cute shooter.
A cuter.
Ow!
Roguelite action. You're fighting yokai?
I don't know, this is really cute. Although I'm not a huge fan of the lighting. Like, this looks like garbage, like, with the lighting.
Yeah, the lighting looks really bad.
Despite the models all being really nice.
I think almost every trailer so far has had actual gameplay.
Yeah!
That's impressive.
What a good show so far!
Yeah. That was like the big problem with like the Summer Games Fest. It was like, it was all CG trailers. There was like no gameplay in any of them. So it was like the most boring shit ever, because he's like, you're showing off a game and it's like, well, I know that's not actually what the game looks like. Or how it is at all. And it tells me nothing about what the game is at all. You know?
What is this? Very rainy. Moody.
Does look neat.
Hello? Anyone here?
Is this like Alone in the Dark?
Ah.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Huh.
This feels like Alone in the Dark. I mean, it could just be a new IP that's like, you know, somewhat similar.
I mean, Alone in the Dark is pretty much just a Lovecraft story to begin with.
Yeah. It's fairly generic as it is, you know.
Yeah.
But this does look pretty cool.
Yeah, it's like a cinematic platformer. I love it. With like a... Well, Lovecraft horror.
It kind of seems to me like a Metroidvania survival horror game.
It's just cool as hell. This looks okay.
This does look actually super awesome. Like, I'm not a big horror guy, but if it's like, this is cool.
You got tentacles everywhere.
Benedict Fox. Oh, that looks really cool.
That looks really interesting. Yeah.
Play day one of Game Pass.
Bonjour, everyone. I am excited to be here today to tell you more about Interior Knights' first original creation, As Dust Falls.
What's As Dust Falls? Do we know about this game?
We might have, but I don't remember. If we've seen it before. If we've seen it before, I don't remember it.
Because stories are brilliant, universal tools that help us understand the heartbreaking beauty of life.
I know what a story is.
This game is an uncompromising.
Why they had Final Destination in the middle there?
And sacrifice, written like a prestige TV show, with a unique motion graphic novel style that triggers
the French are making a British TV show game.
British TV show.
By video games that gives you agency over the lives of far from perfect human beings. This is a thought-provoking experience you can play with people you love. Discover insights about each other and create shared memories. As Dust Falls is an emotional experience that we hope will leave a mark with everyone who plays it.
Okay.
For most people, Turok is just a pit stop.
I guess they couldn't afford animators, so they had to do everything like storyboarded.
It's kind of odd.
Yeah.
You need.
But for us, it felt like a trap.
There's enough cash in that safe to put the last few weeks behind us. On the ground now!
You were in the wrong place at the wrong time. We've been in the wrong place forever.
Sometimes doing the right thing is doing the wrong thing.
Oh, I laughed at that.
None of us escaped that night.
It's okay.
Even those of us who made it out alive.
Like a British TV show. You ever watched a British TV show? I wouldn't know.
Only like the comedies.
They all look back to Turok.
Get rid of the cop.
Hey there.
Evening.
Hey, Sam.
Say, you haven't seen three fellas in a blue pickup, have you?
Nope. Been here all day.
How you liking the desert dream?
Oh, can't complain.
Can I ask what brings you to Turok?
Oh my god, it's a flowchart. Well, I like my flowcharts. Multiplayer? What?
Yeah, you sit on a couch together and then you argue about which option you should pick out of the dialogue branch.
Whoa! Join 10 million players!
Watch out.
Battle Royale! Fortnite!
How much you want to bet this game was backed by the Chinese government?
Huh?
How much you want to bet that this game was funded by the Chinese government?
Oh, it's possible.
It's like...
We needed someone to compete with PUBG, which apparently PUBG is still huge in China for some reason.
Yeah.
It's pretty big in Japan too. There's a lot of like weird anime events for PUBG, which is hilarious.
Yeah. If I had to guess, it's probably the people like living there who are like really into like Western culture, you know?
Okay, yeah, like the Westaboos.
Yeah, I'd imagine it would be like those guys that are playing it.
Okay, Yeah, because Fortnite doesn't go far enough with that.
Yeah, because that's too cartoony, and that doesn't appeal to anyone there, you know?
That doesn't appeal to the hardcore gamers.
Yeah.
The Call of Duty fans.
World premiere.
What's it gonna be? How many games are you making, Xbox Game Studios? Jeez. How many things can you publish?
I mean, a lot. They have billions of dollars.
What the hell is this? This medieval peasant simulator?
When was you spent your Wonder Journey before you came to Tassing? Italy!
What is this? Oh, the...
I mean, it's different.
Obsidian, okay.
Yeah. Anything that's unique gets like an extra 15 point bonus, you know?
This is like really unique and weird. Just, go play medieval.
It also gets like an extra 10 point bonus for not being a first/third person shooter.
Oh man, I'd like to see them make a medieval peasant shooter. See how that works. You just have like a really tiny trebuchet. Ah! Puncho.
Okay. What is gonna come up? You play as a mosquito? Oh, this is the game where you get shrunken down. It's already out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hello, microfriends.
Spider.
Yeah. I know they added like an arachnophobia mode, which turns the spider into like a thing of polygons.
That's nice. I appreciate that. That spider didn't scare me too much, but some spiders get me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know there's a lot of spiders in the game, so, yeah.
But yeah, tiny game, there's nothing else you can do.
Yeah.
I liked, Rot's arachnophobia mode that changed all the spiders into rats.
Yeah. See, the problem with this game is it's not utilizing the Ant Bully IP.
Yes! There is an Ant Bully game in the GameCube back in the day. Yeah. I could never get past the first hour, because I was stupid. I think Vinesauce played that once on a Shovelware Showcase. He gave up after 5 minutes.
Oh, is it finally going out of early access?
I guess so.
See, this is the problem with like games going into early access hours, because like, well, I consider it released when you put it into early access, you know? And then I consider everything after that just to be updates to the base game. Because people just do that anyway. You know?
If you do something like episodic with early access, like something like Dusk did it episodically, like where each episode was released. Like, that worked. Because like each episode is like then an event. Like, yeah, so.
Yeah, that's reasonable. But it's like, if it's like, here's the game, but we're going to add more stuff to it. At that point, it's like, well, you're just launching me an unfinished game and then you promise to give me future updates, you know? It's not that different than what Nintendo does, you know? If they're multiplayer games.
Yeah.
Helios. They search for
someone. Oh no, it's Bastion. For Overwatch. Is this the stealth game?
Probably.
Where their lights are their FOV?
Dude, I love that trope.
Lost. Until now.
I mean, we need more stealth games.
Now they have
awakened. You know, the genre is basically dead. We need more stealth games.
Ah, I'm trying to think, yeah, what stealth games are out.
But I am not their hope. I am their reckoning.
I mean, there's Hitman. Hitman's always doing pretty well.
Yeah, but that's different compared to a lot of other stealth games, you know? This looks really cool.
Oh, yeah.
You like that one JoJo stand from Part 5 that the fat dude had? You can only walk in the shadows or whatever?
Oh, I can't remember that guy.
I don't remember the name of the stand. It's a lie. You know, it was the stand that would only, like, go through shadows and stuff.
Yeah, I think I vaguely remember.
Yeah.
Man, I should rewatch JoJo one of these days. Oh, what's this? So this could be a zombie game?
No. It's a rat eating the corpse. Or is it a dog?
I speak now to those who heed a darker call.
That corpse exploded.
Those bold enough to cross the line of sin for deeper knowledge. Who follow an unquenchable yearning born of blood and bone. To unlock the forbidden secrets and foulest black rituals, calling forth life from death.
Oh, is this gonna be a necromancer game? Wait, why did you bring it back to life just to kill him again, idiot? Idiot.
Truly
embrace this power, you must take it into the world. And you will be shunned. Scorned. Marked as a living sacrifice to this profane knowledge.
Where's the gameplay? What is this game?
I'm trying to figure out if it's like attached to an already existing IP or if it's just a new thing with like, you know, generic themes, you know?
Yeah. Okay, necromancer game. This is cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could have my own skeleton army.
Yeah.
Oh, it's
it is Diablo. Okay, I was like,
oh,
right, because there's a there's a necromancer class in Diablo.
Okay, now I'm not excited.
See, that makes sense.
I'll go play Diablo 1 instead.
See, that was the thing. It was like, it was so generic, it could have been anything, you know?
The Necromancer, a commander of the undead who joins the other iconic classes around the campfire in Diablo 4. These include the Mighty Barbarian.
Have they ever had a Necromancer class in Diablo? I feel like they've had one in the past, in a previous game.
Because the demon Lilith,
I think 3 did.
Yeah.
Has returned and spreading corruption and evil as she fights to
reclaim. A lot of them have, like, definitely have, like, abilities where you can summon, like, minions. That's, like, that's been, like, all of them since 2, I think.
Yeah.
Of the 25-year history of the franchise. Building on top of the best of what's come before with some...
I know that new Diablo phone game they just released was a big, steamy pile of smelly poo-poo.
Well, hearing from a few of the many people behind the game.
Yeah.
And that's to be expected, you know, it's a mobile game.
Great thing about Diablo is it has more ripoffs than any other game ever created, so you can just play those instead.
That's true.
Seriously, there are so many Diablo clones.
Yeah.
It's not for the faint of heart. It's gory and unnerving. It's creepy.
I'm glad it's a bit creepier looking because 2 and 3 are a bit more fantasy.
Right.
Where 1 is like a full-on horror game.
Yeah. Modern games.
That's fine to say.
At least the game still plays the same, and they haven't changed it into a completely different genre, because it's like, this Diablo is you know, in third person, and it's an action RPG. And it's like, why? You know?
Yeah.
It allows you
to
switch around your playstyle as well. It's still a top-down Dungeon Crawler. Do it in
for League of Legends ult.
You know?
Yeah.
One of the really cool things about having
open world
the journey that you take throughout Diablo 4. There's no linear path that you have to follow.
We've got almost 150 dungeons.
Does it count as open world if it's top down?
There's all kinds of surprises as you're exploring.
It's still a open world. I don't know.
Or would that just count as a interconnected dungeon crawler? You know?
You might have a space that begins.
Because like Diablo level design wise is just a dungeon crawler. You know?
Yeah.
A friendly town.
Sometimes it's a new town. Sometimes it's a new dungeon. There's a whole bunch of rewards that you get, and you have a real impact on the world as a result.
No, you can't leave us here. They might come back any moment.
Local events are really cool little.
See, it's so hard to like really know. It's like, will it be more like how Diablo 3 was at launch? Will it be more like Diablo 2?
Yeah.
And it's like,
Will it suck balls? Or
yeah, it's like, and I don't necessarily have a lot of faith in the developers to not mess it up, you know?
Like, can they just promise me this won't have, like, microtransactions and stuff?
Yeah, exactly. Like,
it's so easy to create a community. It makes Diablo more of a social experience.
I don't want Diablo to be a social experiment. I want it to be lonely with me fighting skeletons in the dark.
Well, to be fair, multiplayer has always been a key part of Diablo.
Yeah, it has, yeah. I don't think one had it, actually. I think it was two, but yeah.
Well, yeah,
but two was like the biggest game ever.
Yeah, it's like nobody really thinks, when people think of Diablo, they think of Diablo 2. Like, they don't even think about 1 or 3.
You're also opening yourself to being swung at.
Oh my god, no! People can show up and beat you up!
It's Dark Souls!
I like that blood wave.
Yeah.
That is nice grass, I'll give him that. You know?
The last story mission is really the beginning of a whole different part of the journey. Now you're set up for the end game.
You're just gonna spoil the end of the game?
...that allow you to get more and more powerful.
Whether it's new items or new dungeons or new paragon boards, every single time you
come before,
there's going to be new stuff for you to experience.
And it's something that we're going to support for years to come.
I'm really excited for folks to get their hands on Diablo 4.
Just to see millions of people really enjoying the different options.
I could really go for a good dungeon crawler, actually. I should play one sometime.
Yeah.
It's not Diablo 4. Because I don't want to pay $60 for this.
We are so close.
Oh, you can turn into a bear.
Yeah. I like dungeon crawlers, but I kind of prefer the ultra simplistic ones, like Gauntlet, where it's just like breaking it down to its purest essentials, you know?
Yeah. Did you play Nine Parchments? I've seen that around. That's like pretty much just like Gauntlet style, where it's like borderline just a twin stick shooter.
Yeah. No, I haven't heard of that. I'll have to check it out.
Yeah.
And as this song will spell out, there's plenty to sing about.
Now, what is this game?
It's that rare pirate game. I don't remember the name. But you know, it's been out for years.
Yeah, I forgot what it's called. Sea of Thieves?
Yeah, that one.
Okay. Okay.
Booty
McBooty Face. I want that.
Yeah.
Why is that orb got the, like, Shikia from Zelda symbol?
available with Xbox Game Passive codes.
I'll just answer as a pirate captain.
Pirates should never say Xbox Game Pass. Multiplayer pirate game does sound pretty cool, but I don't know, I never played Sea of Thieves. Yeah. Lucas has played that, yes?
Yeah, probably. Whoa, voxel graphics.
I like voxels. Oh, this looks pretty.
I'm not a big fan of voxel stuff, but this looks actually decent.
Yeah. The lighting makes it a lot more appreciable.
Yeah. The character models don't look voxely, though. Some of them
I think it's the idea that the world there it is voxely. Right. That this character's from a regular world. The protagonist.
But their regular world was also voxely.
No, it looked like it was just the stuff in the barn was voxely.
Maybe.
Okay. Like, I think it was stuff that came from... It's weird, this looks pretty, though.
Yeah, some of the stuff looks very voxely, and then some of the stuff doesn't. Like, inconsistent.
Yeah, I don't know. I like just cool Wonderland look, though.
Yeah, it looks cool.
This is a solid presentation so far, by the way. I don't think there's really been like a low point.
Yeah, they've kept good pace.
They just showed a lot of good games.
It's like already been over an hour.
Oh, lead designer inside Limbo. Okay. You got my eyes. Ew, what is that, like an onion?
Whoa. This looks very different.
Yes.
Than, you know, inside and...
Limbo, yes.
Yeah.
They added another dimension.
It's now top down.
Yes. Oh, this is vibe-y. Wow. Orbs.
Okay.
Oh. Okay. Butterflies.
They couldn't get anybody to say world premiere one time and then use it 50 times over.
I think that'd be more annoying.
Yeah. It's zombies in Japan!
Wow! What's that in the background? An alligator?
Team Ninja. Is it a new Team Ninja action game?
Which one is Team Ninja? I get confused with, like, Ninja Team. Which one did Team Ninja make?
I'm pretty sure there's the... They're the... Ninja Gaiden guys, right?
I think. Wow.
Is it supposed to be in China? I'm guessing it's supposed to be China and not Japan.
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes more sense.
Where's Todd Howard?
Japan is the home to some of the most
hey, Phil Spencer.
And well-known game creators anywhere in the world. We're thrilled to be working with Koei Tecmo to bring Wolong Fallen Dynasty to Game Pass day one. I'm also excited to be working with Team Ninja, who has a long history of building incredible action games for Xbox, and it's great to be working with them once again. We know how important it is to our fans to continue to bring more Japanese franchises to Xbox. I'm excited.
Wow. They understand that, unlike Sony.
Yeah.
One of the most highly requested and beloved franchises to Xbox from our partners at Atlas.
Xbox is okay. Gonna get Persona before the Switch does. We're getting Persona 3.
Persona 3 remake?
I think it might just be a port.
Okay. No, wait, no, this is full on new because that was female protagonist.
It's Persona 3
Portable. Oh, it's Portable. Is it gonna be? Yeah, and it's gonna Golden. Be portable with actual like. It's gonna be portable with actual 3D stuff.
I think it might be. Xbox is getting Persona before
hey,
the Switch.
Hey, these aren't PS4, right? I think these aren't even on PlayStation.
They're not on
at
PS4,
the
no.
That's funny.
Are we gonna get a Persona? Does that mean we're gonna get a Persona 3 port to PC?
That'd be nice. Although, are we only gonna get portable at like Fez? Because Fez has stuff like the Aegis epilogue and everything. Right.
It's coming to Windows.
Oh yeah, Windows Game Store. First. Okay.
E5R, yeah.
I hope it's an upgraded port of Portable.
Yeah, they're coming
portable...
to PC.
Nice, yeah. Mm. I hope it's an upgraded port of Portable though, because Fez is like better in a lot of ways.
I'm excited to announce a special partnership between Xbox Game Studios and one of the greatest creative minds and innovators in our industry. Someone that I have admired for many years.
Todd Howard, come on.
Pleased to share, we will be working together to create a brand new experience like we've never seen before.
Thank Who's you, it going to
be? Oh, it's Kojima.
It's Kojima. He's like...
Now Xbox is throwing money at him.
Yeah.
It's a game I've always wanted to make. I gotta know what this is.
Hope it's not walk to point A to point B simulator again.
Death Stranding is awesome. That walking was so much fun.
<laughs>
Can you tell us what your crazy, wacky idea is, Kojima?
No. But just knowing that the next Kojima game is going to be Xbox.
At Xbox Game Studio.
Okay.
Today,
he's like, after Sony gave me $1 trillion, now you can too.
Yeah.
That you can play over the next 12 months.
Holy shit, if we really...
Today's show celebrates...
We sell a lot of games.
Yeah. Of global game creators. I don't think all of these showed up.
Who bring with them...
But most
of
them
Yeah, a few of these weren't. But yeah.
Games from these creators will be coming to Game Pass.
Good show, Xbox.
Yeah, this is pretty good. There's actually games in here that I'm like, oh yeah, I kind of want to play that.
Yeah, and even the ones I'm not interested with, at least they're like showing us some good gameplay.
Yeah.
Just to name a few.
That's Scorn. I don't want to play that.
Some of the most anticipated titles from the teams at Xbox. And
that Benedict Fox earlier was probably like the most interesting new announcement.
Yeah.
Forza Motorsport and more. This has been an incredible year as we achieved record.
Even Doggo is excited.
And Game Pass.
Oh, sorry. It's just a dog far away.
And we have you to thank for that. Whether that's new.
Well, they still have to show off Starfield, and there's 10 minutes left on the show.
Playing on Xbox and PC.
Yeah, there's 10 minutes left of the show, so I'm guessing all 10 of those are going to Starfield.
I'd better, like, call us degenerates again.
The talented studios at Bethesda Softworks to Xbox.
Yeah!
Their team.
I'm so excited. It's been so long since we've seen him.
Franchises to Game Pass, shipping updates to their games, and building new experiences for you to enjoy. We know that everyone has been eager to see Starfield. Our show today has highlighted gameplay, so it's only fitting that we end it with an extended first look at one of the most anticipated games.
Oh, I'm
in Xbox
actually really
history.
Excited to see Starfield gameplay because I have no clue what it's going to be.
It's Fallout, like, but you get a spaceship.
I know. I want to see how that actually plays out, though. Here, Bethesda's logo kind of lame.
Yeah.
Like, what is it?
It's a gear.
Okay.
It's hard to express how excited all of us at Bethesda are to be here with you today. We're so grateful you're spending the time, and we know you've waited a long time to finally see Starfield. It's easily our most ambitious game ever. Like our previous games, it's an epic role-playing game where you get to be who you want and go where you want. But this time, you'll be exploring space. So let's jump right in. This is early in the game as you arrive on the mysterious moon of Crete.
Robot.
According to the scanners, the abandoned research facility is in this direction.
I can't wait for, you know, Nintendo to show Metroid Prime 4 and it's just gonna be like way better.
No, I'm actually finally a bit more on board with this game. Like, actually seeing like a few seconds of gameplay, even I'm kind of seeing how this is it like this works actually. Yeah. Like a Bethesda space game. Like,
yeah,
oh,
I just
okay.
know that this game is gonna be like the buggiest thing to ever exist. You know? You know what I'm saying? It's like this is gonna be like as buggy as Cyberpunk was. So it's like, I just hope everybody, you know, who goes and buys this game day one, plays it with that mindset of, this is going to be the buggiest game I've ever experienced in my entire life.
Yeah. You know?
So they can get themselves in that mindset of, like, expect the game to crash, expect things to fly across the screen randomly, expect things to just not work, you know, as they're supposed to. That's, you kind of have to just, you know, ready yourself for that, because, you know, they're never going to show off the bugs in the trailer, you know, but they had to re-record this trailer 80 times before they got one without any bugs in it.
Too many horrible bugs in Bethesda games. They have, like, bugs, of course, happen. I've never got, like, anything game-breaking, at least.
I mean, you gotta remember, Fallout 76, you know, that game, you couldn't go 30 seconds without encountering a bug.
Actually, New Vegas is the worst experience I've had of Bethesda bugs, and that one was even developed by them.
Yeah. I mean, you gotta remember, every game in this genre has been the buggiest games ever made. Right. There isn't a single game in this genre that isn't obscenely buggy.
It's kind of unavoidable unless you spend like 10 years of development on a game like this, though, just because of how stupidly huge they are.
The only games like in a genre like this that aren't obscenely buggy are Rockstar games. You know?
Yeah. They're like on a whole other level of budget.
Yeah.
Oh man, they got a hacking minigame and everything.
Yeah, but you know, you gotta remind yourself, it's like Skyrim, very buggy, you know, it's like Fallout New Vegas, very buggy, you know, Fallout 76, very buggy, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like Cyberpunk, very buggy, you know.
It's like, well, that one was a bit extreme even for a genre.
Yeah.
Yeah, this looks neat though. I like the sort of
space. I mean, I have no doubt that people are gonna love it, you know, and it's gonna be pretty good overall, but I'm just saying, it's just like, this game will be buggy as fuck. Yeah, this game's gonna be buggy, right?
That's part of the fun.
Yeah. I'm not saying it's gonna necessarily be bad, I'm just saying it's gonna be buggy, you know?
Yeah.
So it's like, just make sure to temper your expectations along with that, and if you do, you're probably gonna have a good time.
Yeah. Oh my god, it's like the Jetsons. It's cool, like, as far as, like, sci-fi aesthetics look, I think it's kind of a little unique looking. I don't know.
Yeah, I think it looks pretty good overall.
Yeah.
Welcome to Constellation. We have a lot to talk about.
Hey, Bethesda, their faces don't look totally fucked up. Good job, Bethesda.
I do wonder how big the universe in the game is going to actually be, like, how much explorable space there is, you know?
Yeah.
You'll be part of solving that puzzle now.
It's like, how many planets are you going to be able to go to, and how much of the planet are you going to be able to visit, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, you can go to all these planets, but if you can only explore, like, 50 square miles of each planet, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like,
let's say each planet has like the size of like Morrowind's map. I think that's achievable today. Do something like that.
Yeah. You know, because No Man's Sky achieved all of that with, you know, randomly generating everything.
Yeah, yeah. This actually has to have like side quests and stuff and stories happening on each planet.
Yeah.
Look at all these factions they're showing off. The only way out? Like a Bethesda game. The path
ahead may be dangerous. Yeah.
What faction are you gonna join? Yeah.
I'm gonna play. I'm gonna get Prime 4 instead.
You gotta choose the blue guys or the red guys or the.
Forever. Yeah.
Brotherhood of Steel.
Yeah. It's like, you can either choose to become an authoritarian fascist,
battlefield.
Or a chaotic evildoer.
By who you are and the choices you make. And that starts with character creation.
That's why New Vegas is great, because they just made like 60 endings for every possible philosophy you could have.
Yeah.
All the elements of how you look.
Just, you can just murder every faction in New Vegas, and that counts.
Yeah.
You'll pick a background that gives you 3 starting skills.
Ooh, I like my character creation.
Spend some time as a
dude. Yeah.
Having a way with words might prove useful.
There are optional traits, and these come with unique advantages and disadvantages.
I'm hoping those like backgrounds have a slightly different start, because a big problem with a lot of Bethesda's RPGs is they just have like this really lame start that makes some like new playthroughs not super fun.
Right.
And you can unlock new skills.
Like you have to do the whole Fallout 3 intro every time you want to do a new playthrough. Yeah.
Yeah.
Deep crafting systems from running research projects with.
I mean, they usually have like a thing where it's like, would you like to change your character? Like, you can save before that.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I'd like more like mini openings for different backgrounds and stuff. That'd be nice.
Yeah. I think this game will be good. Once again, I am expecting it to be very buggy, though.
Build your own outpost.
No. That's what I'm expecting. I'm expecting like really good, but also. But
oh,
still
you can
buggy,
make your own outposts.
You know?
That's gonna be goofy.
And you can hire characters you meet to keep it up and running.
Oh, that's kind of neat.
But that's not all.
It's like your house in Skyrim, except for actually fleshed out.
Your own spaceships.
Oh, I want to do that.
You can choose crew members.
I have a coconut tree in my spaceship.
And yes, you can completely customize the look and layout.
Good.
There's loads.
Okay, this actually looks pretty neat.
Yo, you can make a gummy ship.
I have to say, it's so cool.
Yeah.
Absolutely love this.
So basically,
shit,
this game is Kingdom Hearts, but with
ship,
worse combat.
Performs from engines to shields to weapon systems, because yes, you can fly it.
Thrusters boosted.
I think this is the game people wanted from No Man's Sky.
Yes, I'd say, yeah, that seems about right.
This giant, like, space simulator where you could just do anything.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because, hey, making your own spaceship alone is, like, kind of, I assume, like, dream game for a lot of people. I mean, that sounds cool as hell.
Yeah. Like I said, I think this game is going to be really good. It's also probably going to be fairly buggy, because you can't really make a game on this scope without it ending up being buggy, you know?
Yeah. I'm glad we're finally seeing gameplay of this, though.
Yeah.
Because it's kind of just been like a weird nebulous thing for years. Oh man, asteroids.
Yeah. I mean, like, even Rockstar limits themselves to cowboys and just a single city, you know?
Yeah. I hope we can get a bootleg lightsaber in this game.
There probably has... I mean, it's like, I'm assuming, like, the combat isn't too far off from Fallout, so...
Yeah.
You know, there's probably gonna be, like, melee build options.
Yeah.
For all of you to experience the game, thanks again for being with us today, and thanks for all the support.
For being an hour and a half, that
especially
didn't
game,
feel like an hour and a half, you know?
That was an excellent presentation, just
yeah,
in general.
Overall, yeah.
This was great.
Yeah. And I want to emphasize, I'm not like worried about Starfield being bad. I'm just like, I'm like very specifically, I think it's going to be really good, but it's probably going to be fairly buggy, you know? And so as long as you temper your expectations where it's like, this game's probably going to have a lot of bugs. But besides that, it's going to be an amazing, you know, space RPG. You know?
Yeah.
So it's like, as long as you go in with the mindset, it's like, this is not going to be perfect. But it's going to be really fucking cool. And you're going to love it, you know? So, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, you can just go anywhere on the planet. It's just a lot of it's barren, of course.
That
makes
sense.
open for you to explore.
How many planets did he say?
To see what
I think
find.
He said 1,000 planets.
1,000?
I thought think he that's said 90. He said. Oh, well, either way, I don't know. I'll have to play it back.
Yeah.
Either way, that either number is a shitload.
Yeah.
Dinosaurs! So I'm gonna assume a lot of planets don't have like a ton going on like story-wise, but you know, there'll probably be like roving NPCs and stuff that can probably make a story on like any planet, you know?
Right.
Like that kind of stuff could happen.
I also imagine you'll probably occasionally run into like an NPC or whatever just out in space where they're like, hey, my ship ran out of fuel. Can you bring me some? You know, shit yeah, like that.
But then it turned out to be pirates or something.
Yeah.
Or xenomorph.
Yeah.
Hey! <Yeah. laughs> You've sold me on Starfield. I need to get a PS5 or something, though, because this game's probably going to run like shit on PS4.
Well, it's not going to be on PS4. It's an Xbox exclusive.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It'll be on PS5 eventually, right? After like 3 years.
No, it's Microsoft owns Bethesda. It's coming to PC and Xbox. There was a lot of cool games they showed off, and they actually bothered to show off gameplay for pretty much all of them.
Yeah.
This was really good. This was drastically better than the game show, you know, Summer Games Fest.
Yeah.
They actually had Silk Song, right?
Yeah, we saw Silk Song gameplay. That's what people have been begging for.
Yeah.
We saw it on Xbox.
I don't think it should, like, a release date, though.
Yeah.
So.
Nah, that's fair. I guess maybe they don't want to commit.
Yeah. And there was like a good variety in like the kinds of games, you know, they weren't all
yeah,
space
just
horror
all
games
shooters.
And space horror games. There was a lot of cool shit shown off here.
Yeah, this is excellent.
This was really fucking good. I was actually impressed. This was like the best Xbox like E3 showcase they've ever done. Like easily.
Yeah, maybe.
I can't remember a single one that has even come close. You know?
Yeah.
As someone who, like, doesn't care at all about Xbox, has never owned an Xbox at all, this was actually really awesome.
It's very nice that all their games are on PC now, too.
Yeah. Yeah, that was very good.
Yeah, I'm looking up I was looking up Benedict Fox just for its name. Apparently it is straight up. They described it as a Lovecraftian Metroidvania.
Oh, that is awesome. I'm totally going to get that game. That's so awesome.
That was probably the most exciting game, honestly.
Yeah. Let's see. How many planets can you explore in Starfield?
To Goldilocks planets with life. And not just this system, but over 100 systems. Over 1,000 planets, all open for you to explore.
Yeah, over 1,000 planets. There's 100 solar systems and 1,000 planets in total.
My god!
Right, only like so many of them are gonna be like Goldilocks planets, you know.
Yeah, only so many are gonna be like, you know, civilized. That all makes sense.
Yeah,
about, like, the game itself, you know.
Yeah,
you can make your own outposts. You can colonize space.
Yeah. Yeah. Overall, this was good. It was a lot better than the Sony.
I'm more interested in Redfall than I was before, and I was already excited for Redfall.
Yeah, Redfall looks neat. Yeah. I'm not super excited for it, but you know, I tried Borderlands 2 and I didn't care for it at all. So I'm assuming it's like it's probably going to be very similar to that because that's what it seems like.
Yeah. Yeah, but Borderlands 2's gameplay is I think Borderlands' issue is it's writing.
I didn't really care for it at all. So.
Yeah, yeah. We saw too much Riot Games stuff.
That was a little excessive.
But, yeah. It's not a solid show. Xbox.
Yeah, we saw a stealth game. We saw, like, you know, a turn-based strategy game. Oh, that one was.
We saw Minecraft.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There was a lot of good shit in this.
Yeah.
They didn't all look the same either.
There was
a lot of variety.
Yeah, shocking.
Overall, like, two thumbs up. This was fucking good.
Yeah, great. Excellent.
Yep. And I think that's about it. I want to go eat because I haven't had lunch yet. So I'm hungry.
All right.
So we're going to end it here. Thanks for watching. Pretty cool. That one was nice. Yeah.